Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Let's discuss the basics of electric circuits. An electric circuit is typically composed of electrical loops, which can include items such as wires, batteries, resistors, light bulbs, capacitors, switches, ammeters, voltmeters, and inductors. Each of those circuit elements is typically illustrated using the symbols I am showing here. I'm not going to talk about each individual circuit element right now. We will get plenty of opportunities to talk about all of these over the course of the next few lessons.
What is an inductor?
No idea.
I'm sure he'll talk about it eventually.
Okay.
Let's look at a simple circuit with a battery and a resistor connected by wires. The long line of the battery is the positive terminal of the battery, and the short line is the negative terminal. Next to the battery, I'm going to place a lowercase Greek letter epsilon. Epsilon is the symbol for electromotive force, which is often called the EMF of the battery. The electromotive force, or EMF, of a battery is the ideal electric potential difference, or voltage, across the terminals of the battery.
Hold up. I thought lowercase epsilon was the symbol for electric permittivity.
It is. Lowercase epsilon is the symbol for both EMF and electric permittivity.
Ugh.
So electromotive force is not a force. It is an electric potential difference?
I guess electromotive force is another misnomer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. According to the law of charges, positive charges are repelled from the positive terminal of the battery and attracted to the negative terminal. Therefore, the electric current in the circuit is clockwise. I've illustrated that with an arrow indicating that the electric current goes down through the resistor in our circuit. Okay, I am now going to compare the energies of a single charge moving through the circuit to the mechanical energies of a mass. Realize there are many, many more charges than just this one charge moving through the circuit. However, right now we are just looking at the energies of that single charge. And let's make the battery a 3-cell battery, so the length of the battery in the circuit diagram is roughly the same as the length of the resistor. Billy, please compare the energies of the mass to those of the electric charge being shown here.
Absolutely. As the charge moves up through the battery, the charge gains electric potential energy, just like the mass gains gravitational potential energy as you lift it. As the charge moves along the top of the wire, its electric potential energy stays constant, just like the mechanical energy of the mass stays constant as it sits at the top of the wall. As the charge moves down through the resistor, the electric potential energy of the charge is converted to heat energy, just like the gravitational potential energy of the mass is converted to kinetic energy. And then, as the charge moves along the bottom wire, its electric potential energy again stays constant, just like, again, the mechanical energy of the mass stays constant as it sits on the ground. And then the whole process is repeated.
But what about the resistance of the wires? We just derived the resistance of wires. Shouldn't the resistance of the wires affect what happens here?
Oh, right. Sorry. Unless otherwise stated, all wires are considered to be ideal wires and have zero resistance. As charges move along a wire with zero resistance, the charge will experience zero change in electric potential energy. That is what is happening in the wires at the top and bottom of the circuit and is analogous to the mass at rest at a constant height at either the top or bottom of the wall. Now, I do want to take a few moments to look at a color-coded demonstration of what we just talked about for the electric potential energy of electric charges moving through this circuit. Notice I am now illustrating many more of the electric charges moving through the circuit. You can see, Bo, tell me what you see.
Sure. Looks like you have chosen the color blue to illustrate the minimum electric potential energy of the charges, and red to illustrate the maximum electric potential energy of the charges. And this is pretty much what Billy just said. As charges move through the battery, they go from blue to red because they gain electric potential energy. As charges move along the top and bottom wires, the charges maintain a constant color because they maintain a constant electric potential energy because the wires are ideal and have negligible resistance. As charges move through the resistor, their color goes from red to blue because their electric potential energy is being converted to heat. And if this resistor were a light bulb instead, it would also be converting the electric potential energy of the charges to heat, light, and sound energy. That's it. That's all I see.
Thank you, Bo. Notice this means the positive side of the resistor is at the top of the resistor in our diagram, and the negative side of the resistor is at the bottom of the resistor in our diagram. This is because the charge has its highest electric potential energy at the top, therefore the electric potential of the resistor is highest at the top. And the charge has its lowest electric potential energy at the bottom, and therefore the electric potential of the resistor is lowest at the bottom. Notice, this means the electric potential across the resistor goes down in the direction of the current, just like the electric charges moving through the resistor experience a decrease in their electric potential energy.
Electric potential across a resistor decreases in the direction of current, so the electric potential difference in the direction of current across a resistor is negative. Got it.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.